Hello YouTube. So today we're going to be doing another Windows 10 video. Of this time of what I consider the third sort of generation of Windows 10, the previews at least, is build 10,074 or 174, however you want to say it. The Windows 10 Insider Preview is what they renamed it, because that was originally the Technical Preview, then the Technical Preview 2, and now Insider Preview. So the last time I did a video about Windows 10 was back with build 9926 in January. And, I'd say quite a bit's changed since then, and it's really starting to look like what the final version will be. At least that's what I can tell. And there's quite, you know, there's actually a number of new things that I do like that are in this. And it does feel more refined. So I'm going to install it on my Lenovo ThinkPad R61, so I just got it on this USB flash drive here, so just plug that in. Let's turn the machine on. This currently has build 141 on here, so if I press any key to boot from USB, so it's going to boot into the Windows 10 setup. So yeah, currently I have build, 141, or 10,041, however you want to say it, on this. And that build, it's I did direct upgrade from 9926, so it's kind of a little bit unstable on this. So hopefully a fresh install will fix it. So there we go. So still looks like Windows setup has been since Windows 8. So I'm just going to select my language. Actually, I'll leave it as English United States, so we can get Cortana. That's what you have to do. You have to leave it as the US region and language, so you can get Cortana, which, Well, actually, I think it does work in Australia now. It might. But I like to leave it as US because you get the proper American voice. With it, if you leave it on Australia, at least on the Windows Phone, you get the British voice, and I don't like that. It doesn't, it's because it's not an actual real voice, doesn't have a real voice actress. The US version does, so it actually sounds proper. So, yeah. For those interested, the specifications of this machine is a Intel Core 2 Duo at the T7250, I think is what this is. At 2 gigahertz, it's got 2 gigabytes of RAM, and even though I am installing the 64-bit version of Windows 10, I actually did order some RAM off of eBay, so yeah. Alright, so we have quite a few partitions here, so I'm gonna just delete all these. There goes unallocated space. So if I just click next, it's going to do that automatically. Yeah, so as the Core 2 Duo at 2 gigahertz, T7250, I think is what it is. It's got 2 gigabytes of RAM, but I did order some RAM off eBay, so I bought 4 gigabytes of DDR2 memory. So, and it wasn't that expensive either. So, you know, someone actually, on one of my videos about the R61, someone offered me $100 for 4 gigabytes of DDR2 RAM. That's way overpriced. Like, I paid, like, less than a third of that. It has the Intel, integrated graphics, the GMA, it's the 4500, HD, I think is what it is. No, that's wrong. Has the GMA X3100 or X1300 or whatever it is, and I forgot. And it's got a 500 gigabyte 7200 RPM hard drive in there. So yeah. So we're gonna be installing this, and we'll be back once we're at the next stage of setup. Right, a couple of reboots later, and we're at the next part of the setup. And they're still going on with this extreme whiteness, which I'm not a big fan of, and it's really kind of screwing up with the exposure on the camera. But anyways, so connect to Wi-Fi. You can see they fixed the little password box set for the Wi-Fi. Before, it didn't actually have a border around it, so all you saw was the flashing cursor. So I'm gonna put the password in, and yeah, so. Alright, there we go. So, you can see they've actually changed the, sort of the theme and the setup to this light blue color, which I actually like quite a bit more. It's actually, this light blue and white actually reminds me of the theme I use with my YouTube channel. So, if I just go, there's no, use express settings or back, but the custom settings, there's this little link down here. So, yeah, so let's go custom settings. So let me just adjust the camera a bit because I need to be a bit closer to the screen. Okay, so personalization, it says personalize my speech by sending data to Microsoft, turn it off. No. Yes. Yep, alright, next. It says use smart screen services. In Windows browsers, I use No, turn that off. I don't want them to see my browsing history. let's see. It says automatically correct. Automatically connect to open networks. No. Automatically connect to network. Share with my contacts. No. And send problem reports to Microsoft. No. So there's quite a few new settings in this actually. It's a bit different than 8.1. So it's gonna load up the Microsoft account page, and they've actually kind of they've changed the way you create local accounts now. It's still the same sort of way it is in 8.1. They've just changed some of the wording around. Like you have to go create a new Microsoft account, and then I think if there's a link that says create a local account, but yeah, it says this. Alright, so who owns this PC? You can connect it to a company sort of thing. I think that's one of the new Windows 10 features, or just a standard PC. So I'm gonna go, this computer belongs to me. Next. So yeah, you can create, you can sign in with your Microsoft account or create a new account. So I'm gonna sign in with my Microsoft account. So if I just. So it's just taking its sweet old time to load. It's probably gonna ask me for like an authentication code and it'll send it to my email. Ah, yes, what's this? It says, meet Cortana. Let me see if I can read this. It says, Cortana is a blah, 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 blah. I know what Cortana is, it says. All right, so next. This didn't show up before in a virtual machine, but I think that's because I set the regional language to Australian. Yeah, what's it doing now? Hi. Oh, it's, oh, it's still, that's a little bit buggy there, but it's still got the same 8.1 thing here. It didn't ask me for an authentication code this time. I'm surprised it didn't do that. Because usually, like, with Windows 8.1 and previous builds of Windows 10, you sign in with your Microsoft account, and then it asks for an authentication code that sends that code to your email, to one of your, like, your secondary email address you have connected to the account, and then it'll ask you to put the code in, and then you do that, and then it'll set it up. But surprised it didn't do that this time. It just let me sign in with my Microsoft account, and yeah. So it's gonna be setting up this now. So I'll be back once we're past this. All right. So there we go. the Windows 10 desktop. And, yeah, still got the same wallpaper here, which I don't really like this. I think in the final version they should change it, but, which they probably will. That's, the beta versions of Windows always have a different wallpaper. Anyway, so, probably need to install drivers first, but, yeah, I can see it's a little bit laggy, but, can see. Start menus. A few things have changed. We can see the power button is down the bottom now, and yeah, I am going to install the drivers, and then I'll be right back. All right. So all the drivers are installed now. So you can see Windows 10 is working. Some of the new features of this is, well, you can see how everything is sort of got a dark look to it now. If I open Action Center, you can see it's black. And, yeah, but we still have, you know, the matching theme color. So, if I just go into the personalize it, they've actually replaced a lot of the control panel elements with into the PC settings now. So if you right-click on the desktop, you can see it says, instead of screen resolution, it says display settings. But if you actually click that, it opens it to the PC settings thing now. So everything, even though the legacy control panel still actually exists, see if I just go into it. There is the legacy control panel. But the but what they want you to use is this new system settings. So if I just make this window a little bit larger, so we don't get scroll bars. You can see, no, this is what they want you to use, and I've actually integrated a lot of stuff into this. So if I just go back into that there. If I go into system, pretty much on all of the settings, you can see advanced. And then if you want to do, say, clear type fonts, it'll bring up the classic clear type font control panel there. Or if I want to go display adapter properties. This worked in the virtual machine. It will bring up the adapter settings. And stuff like that. Or let me give you a better example. If I go notifications. See if I go, turn system icons on or off. That's not it. Select which appear on the taskbar. No, that's been integrated into the new way. Action Center, there we go, it brings up the classic Action Center. So pretty much all the, you know, settings in this new PC settings app, you know, oh whoops, sorry about that, bring up, you know, at the bottom they'll have like a link that says advanced or more options, and it'll bring up the classic control panel. So I actually do like the way they've done it. If I go into personalization here though, this is what I wanted to show you, is that if I go colors, you can see automatically match with my background. That's been there since Windows 8. You can turn it off though, and then you can choose an ascent color just like on Windows Phone. So if I want to choose red, there we go. If I go into the start menu, you can see these elements here, generic tile colors or generic icons, will show up as red. Just like they do on a Windows Phone, if you have a generic color tile or a transparent color tile, it will show up as what your ascent color is, which I like that. I actually do like that a lot. And there's this other thing here. It says show color on the taskbar and start menu. Right now it's turned off. If I turn it on, it turns red or whatever color you have it to. Action Center as well is red. Everything is whatever color you set it to. If I choose this piss yellow here, you can see that now it's yellow. And if I do that, now if I also refresh the, yeah, it opened that like three times. If I go into personalize again here, you can see now the PC settings app is all yellow. Or I don't like this yellow color. I'm gonna go something with a bit better. I'm gonna go red again. There we go. Cause that's a, you know, noticeable color that's different. So if I go personalize here, you can see now this application's red, and different, you know, system these universal applications can do this. So this is the only one I've looked at that can do it. There might be a few others, I don't know. I've only played around with this virtual machine for like half an hour, so. See, color, backgrounds, it doesn't, there's not really many system backgrounds. You can see, when you go browse, you get a proper file browser now. Never used to in these universal apps. But if I go show color in the taskbar and start and turn it off, you get the black theme. So now Windows is on par with OS X. So, which, because OS X, Yosemite has the dark theme. Now Windows has something like that too, which I do appreciate. One thing I wish Windows did have is that these title bars here, you can see they've actually removed all the color from the title bars in the window. See, it's all gray, no matter what color I select. See, I have red. And see these title bars at the top are gray still. Doesn't matter what you choose, they're always going to be gray. Which I wish if you selected this dark theme, it would make it as a dark gray. So they do kind of look boring and generic, but you know, whatever. At least now, Win32 applications like the Windows Explorer will match these universal applications. They never used to. The Win32 apps would have whatever color you selected as the title bar color, or as the window border color, whatever. Whatever theme color you selected, but the universal apps would stay gray. Now all of them are gray. So I guess that makes all match now, so you really can't tell. There's really not much of a difference in terms of the user interface between Win32 and the universal apps. So, whoops, wrong button there. And you can make the start menu transparent or not. Now, another thing that they did in Windows 10 is they brought back some arrow look to things. You can see now, if you look at the detail in the start menu, just loosen the tripod, you can see that, look at the text behind my name there. You can see now it has sort of a blurred effect. So it's really actually, they're bringing back some of the error transparency look from Windows 7 and Windows Vista. So some users apparently get this and some don't. I'm one of the lucky ones that does. So, but you can see that they did that. So if I uncheck that though, now the start menu will be a matte. Just a solid color like it is in Windows 8. So, you know, you can choose whatever look you want. You can, if you like the Windows 8 look, you can have it flat, like just a solid color. Or if you like the Windows 7 look, you can have it like this, where it's got the light, it's transparent, but it has the blurred look to it in the background, which I do like a lot, and I probably will use that if that's in the final version, which I hope it is, because it actually does look pretty nice. Some people want that look in the title bars and stuff, so it has this sort of full Windows 7 arrow effect. I don't care either way, but I do appreciate, I do like the fact that they put it in. So yeah, lock screen, same as what it was before, and themes, you can go to the classic control panel for changing your, so we go theme settings, you get the classic control panel. However, if you look at the bottom here, you can see that there is no, you can't change your background options down here anymore. It's not there. But if you wanted to change like your screensaver or your mouse pointer, so if I got mouse pointer settings, there we go, just bring you straight to this. If you want to change desktop icons, it will bring you straight to that. Sometimes windows don't appear on top of this, I don't know why. But there we go, there's your desktop icon settings. And you can see, they fixed that ugly recycle bin icon and put a nice new one in. And it actually reminds me of the Windows 95 and 98 recycle bin, except it's like that sort of shape, which, you know, that's nice. It does look nice, but, you know, it's just an icon. Who gives a fuck? Sound settings. There we go. Where is the screensaver settings? I'm curious where they are. Oh, they're in the lock screen. There we go. So screensaver is there. And for screensavers, you still have the ones that have been in there since Windows 7 and Windows Vista. So there we go. No new ones, unfortunately. I'd like to see some new screensavers, but, you know, I guess no one really uses, not many people use screensavers anymore. I still do, but, you know, I'm old school. There we go, in background. So I'm going to leave this red. Actually, yeah, I'm going to leave it as red for now. Because, yeah, it actually doesn't look too bad, even though I'd prefer blue. Actually, I will change it to blue. There we go. I like the blue color. No, I'd leave it as red just so I know it's a little different, because the default is blue. So, there we go. What else? This, of course, includes the Project Spartan browser. Let's go through, so that's sort of the settings changes. You can see down in the notification area, they've actually changed some of the taskbar elements. If I go down here, you can see if I click on the clock, you can see you get a new clock thing here. So instead of the one that's, I'll show you what was in previous version of the Windows. This is Windows 8.1 that's on my my main computer. You can see this is the old clock settings that we've had forever. So that's been like that. Now in Windows 10, it's like this. So you have additional clocks up here, and I think you can. I don't think it's limited to two anymore. So if you go advanced settings, additional clocks. It takes you to the alarms app, and make this my primary. Yes, you can add as many as you want. So, and I guess that would all show up in here. So that's cool. And the calendar is a bigger calendar too, so that's good for me, I suppose, since I do like having all big text because it's easier for me. Of course, the action center there. There is a new volume control. Unfortunately, there is no. Where's the volume mixer? In the old volume control. You go volume, so you click mixer there, and then you can choose individual volume. Oh, I'm not even pointing at screen. Shit. If you go to the old volume control, you click mixer, and then you get all these separate volume controls, which that's good because sometimes when I'm on Skype and I want to play a game, I want to turn the Skype or the game volume down, which that is useful. Why is that not here? Unless if it is, and I'm completely, not seeing it. If I right-click on the sound icon, what does it do? So, open volume mixer. Oh, there we go. So you have to, it's one extra step. You have to right-click and go open volume mixer, rather than clicking the mixer inside the volume control. Volume, see, you can see in the volume control, even that's red. So, I do like how Windows works a little bit like Windows Phone in the themes now, where you have an accent color as well as just a general background color as black, which I do like. And that wasn't like that in Windows 8. Although 8.1 was kind of like that, but it wasn't system-wide. It was only within the Metro stuff. With Windows 10, it looks like it's system-wide, which I do appreciate. Networks, of course, the network control panel looks, it pops out just like the way Windows 7's did. It doesn't take up half the screen like Windows 8's one did, so even though it's quite big, and doesn't really need to be this big, whatever, and you have your Wi-Fi in airplane mode, and I guess if you have a machine with mobile broadband, it would show up there as well. And then your battery, which this laptop doesn't actually have a properly working battery, but if I unplug it for a sec. There we go, it's actually live, so you don't have to refresh it all the time. It's actually live, so it's 100% remaining. And the battery, it does work in this laptop not very well. But if I plug it back in, you can see it changed from 100% remaining to fully charged. So, I don't like to run this laptop on the battery, though it's not very good. And then here, of course, you have extra stuff like your OneDrive, which if you just, there we go, it's just OneDrive, and then that's my Intel graphics controller there. So you can see if I go into the start menu, I'll show you some changes here. You can see, of course, one change I mentioned before was the power button is now down the bottom, back where it should be. Although I think what they should do, they should swap the positions of the all apps and power, so power is actually down here. And all apps is here. It'd make a bit more sense. But power, there we go, and it'll bring up sleep, shut down, and restart. And of course you have your recently added there, and then most used, which that will change over time. File Explorer, download documents and settings. I don't know why they have both here, because I guess maybe you go straight to your documents, although I personally don't store anything in the My Documents folder. I just use an external drive on my main machine. And then you log out, and then you use the settings here, like you can change user account, lock, and sign out. One change I do really like a lot, though, and this will actually be very useful for people who don't like Windows, Windows 8 or the live tiles, is that the start menu is resizable again. It used to be like this in build 9841, 9860, and 9879, with the older style start menu that looked a lot like Windows 7's one, more than like it looked, because this is Windows 10's, you know, your own start menu, but the original one that they showed off that looked a lot like Windows 7 and all the tiles bolted onto it. You could resize it if you unpinned all the tiles. It would just show up as like one small menu. They removed that in 9926, which, you know, I didn't like that, the fact that they removed that, but they added this functionality where you could click to go full screen and then it would be, you know, like Windows 8.1. And, fuck's sakes, it's doing this bug again where won't let you into the start menu. Hold on, now how to fix this. You gotta resize the taskbar, I think. Now it's working. Alright, yeah. It's just a little bit buggy. Sometimes the start menu doesn't pop up. But, yeah. So, they added this functionality where you can have it full screen, but, I only like that tablet mode, I guess, on something like a Surface. But, now, if you unpin all the tiles, which, you can actually resize the menu. So if I just, you can drag it, there we go. So now, it's more like what a Windows phone would be with the three columns, on a, like a larger Windows phone. And then if I unpin them all, I can resize it again further just to have this small menu here. I did that in a VM. I don't want to take all the time to unpin all these tiles here. I couldn't be bothered, but, yeah. So, that's the start menu improvements. You can see it's actually a lot easier to rename groups. All you have to do is just click on the group and then rename it. In previous builds, it was a pain in the ass to try and, like, you had to click in a certain, like, you have to try and find, like, this little button here. It wouldn't pop up all the time. And you'd have to try and, like, click this exactly little button and then rename it. At least that's the way it was for me. And, yeah, so now I'm going to have a look at new applications, since there are, you know, a few new apps, that are in this, well, redesigned. So if I go calendar and mail, these have been redesigned to work like the phone versions, so with the new sort of user interface, since, you know, Metro is dead, essentially, the way they want you to do that. And so Outlook, so there's Outlook Calendar and Outlook Mail now, that's what they've been rebranded to. So if I could get started, and then just connect my Microsoft account. Done. You can see it has a brand new user interface. If I just make this full, maximize this. See, we have the hamburger menu, the controversial hamburger menu up here. And that's like that in a lot of Windows 10 apps. And that, I guess that's the way the user interface is going to be now. Yeah. So you can see the calendar. This is the first time of using this, actually. In the virtual machine, I didn't have my Microsoft account linked, so I couldn't use it. So I guess, so there's my calendar, and, if I just, uncheck, you know, I can uncheck what I want. There we go, just uncheck all that. If I go work week, you can do week, month, and the day. Oh, no, that's today, so if I just scroll down, it's like, what's, like, February, and if I click today, it'll jump me back to today, which is the 2nd of May. So, if I just go, day view is there, there we go. Oh, you get, so 6th day, what's this? Okay, that's interesting. So day, you get this, like, little menu here. You can click that and then choose whatever. I just do. I like keeping it on month view just because that's just what I use in regular Outlook. I don't know if I'll use these or not. I probably will. I might on my Surface maybe, since I do like using the touch apps because that is a touch device. But on a regular PC, I just use regular Microsoft Outlook for all my calendar stuff. So there we go. So you can check different calendar things here. So there we go. That's Outlook Calendar. You can choose there's different things here. Mail. There we go. It opens the Mail app. If I click Get Started, connect my email. And there we go. So so if I just make it full screen here, I'll maximize it. You can see it kind of looks like the Windows 8 Mail app as well as Microsoft Outlook at the same time. Because the regular Windows 8 Mail app had, the three columns. You had your folders here, the messages, and then the messages list, and then the message here. So if I click this message here, it should open. There we go. So, a person uploaded a video. So there we go. So, and then if we click this, you can see there's all my other folders. And that one. Fuck off, go away. There we go, alright. Oh, and there we go, so I can, send a new message. Discard there, so there's different options here. If I go, there's the hamburger menu, and I can open and close that. Click, that's how to create a new message. And now that these apps are, designed for touch. These are, the universal apps. Now you have built-in formatting. This app is replacing the Windows 8 Mail app. And so now you have proper formatting in this because it's supposed to be Outlook. So there we go, you have bold, underline. The old ones didn't have that, so it was very basic. And I think the phone versions have this too, so that's why it's universal. So that's Mail and Calendar. And you can see the live tile there, although let me see if I can resize it to wide. Oh yeah, the live tile does work. I heard rumors that it didn't. It's a little bit, that tile does look a little buggy, but let me drag it back to where it's supposed to go. No. Whatever. It's, fuck's sake, now it's not even opening the menu. There we go. Alright, can you move back to where you went? See, this is the problem. I'm not even holding the mouse right now, and it's, stuck in the middle. Yeah, it's not the most stable thing. It's not the most, shit. Yeah. So, that's that. So, Mail Calendar. If we just go... There's a new camera app, although I won't be able to show you that since this laptop does not have a webcam built in. Let's see what else. Some games, that's still the same. Health and fitness, that's still the same. Inside of Mail, maps, I should do that. I think that's still the same as it was last time. Let me have a look. The maps has the map, the redesigned maps has been in here for a while. Oh, it's black now. Oh, that's nice. No, not yet. But you can see, of course, hamburger menu, which a lot of people don't like. I personally don't care. On the phone, it's kind of on the desktop, it's actually, hamburger menus are nice, and they're nice to use, but on the phones, especially Windows Phone, because we haven't had them, people don't like them because they're inferior to the way the modern UI works on a phone. I do agree with that, and, but... Whatever. I'll just adapt to the way they do things. I don't really care. There actually is a new Solitaire application. They've redesigned the Solitaire to the way Windows 10 works. So now you can actually properly play Solitaire in a window. If you downloaded the Windows 8 Solitaire application on Windows 10, it was very buggy and it didn't adjust to window resizing properly because it wasn't designed for that in the first place. Now they say, so if I go Klondike, which hopefully it wasn't loading for me in a virtual machine. Hopefully I can. Oh yeah, it does work. So there we go. So I know how to play Solitaire. Close. There we go. So you can see hamburger menu at the top there. And you know, this, you know, if I maximize, there we go, it works a lot like the Windows 7 Solitaire does. You know, if I make it bigger, it gets bigger. If I make it small, it goes small, so there we go. Oh crap, it's 3-card Solitaire. I don't like 3-card Solitaire. Your undo button's down there, and yeah, it's Solitaire. I mean, I know how to play, just I don't like the 3-card Solitaire. I only like 1 card. I play it the easy way. but yeah. Anyways. Microsoft Money, that's been redone. All the majority of the Bing apps have been redone, except for Food and Drink and, I mean, sorry, not Bing, MSN. I forgot they rebranded them, but a lot of these MSN apps have been redone to look like, you know, Windows 10 apps. You can see the theme that they're going with these universal apps is vertical scrolling instead of horizontal scrolling that we've been, you know, seeing in Windows 8. See, now it's vertical scrolling. It's a lot better for a desktop machine like this. This makes sense. The Windows 8 apps in a window did not make sense. They weren't designed to run in a window, and now they've redone it like this. This feels like a desktop application. Then you have the menu here, you have all your different things, settings, there we go, and then you have a back button there, and different things. So I'm not going to go too in depth with it. A lot of these all the same are the same now. So they all have that sort of new interface with hamburger menus. Music, and there is a new music preview, like the whatever the next version of the Xbox Music app is going to be. It's very basic. It's very similar to the current Xbox Music and Xbox Video apps. There's a video version of that as well. News, that's just like the again, if I click news here, which I don't know why it's like that color now. It used to be like sort of a pinkish red. You know, all these MSN apps have been redone like this. And the only one I actually care about is the weather app. So I wish there was one thing that they would change, and that's if you go all apps here, that it would, if you like scroll all the way down, that it would, and then the next time you go into it, it would keep your position there. Or if you click the letters, it would sort of do what Windows Phone does and let you select from a different letter to jump to, a jump list. OneNote, I think that's the same as what it was before. People, yeah, they redid the People Hub, which I haven't had a proper look at this yet. Oh, and it crashed. Yeah, I don't think that actually works. And it might show my show my contact info. So I'll have a proper look at that later. Let's see. Photos, that's the same as it was before, the redesign photos app. Let's see, find some new settings. Sports, that's another one that's been redone. The store, the beta store actually works now. I never could get that to work. It might have worked for other people, I never could. It always just would just crash on me on this. There's a video preview, voice recorder, which is the same as what sound recorder was. Weather, there we go. So the weather app, of course, been redone like the rest of them. Yes. Alright. There we go. So you can actually run it in a small window now, which is what I do like. There we go. So vertical scrolling, and I mainly use the weather app for the live tile. It's, you know, really nice on the phone. So I wonder if we'll get the updated live tile there. Maybe not. I don't know. It'll work eventually. There's also, I forgot to mention, there's also like a new animation for live tiles as well. So let's see. The majority of this is all the same. So another thing I wanted to show is search. You can see now it's integrated into the start menu. So if I just go over here, you can see Cortana. There we go. Alright, so what's this? To help an injured speaker, can I turn on yes. What would you like me to call you? Alright. Put my name in. Alright, here's how I'll say it. Alright, so just play that. Whatever, I know how I'll say my name. Alright. There we go, done. So now we got Cortana is now, look, now it's integrated into the start menu, so it doesn't feel like a, you know, just a separate pop-up. So there we go. So what you can do now is, if I disable the search box on the taskbar there, if I open the start menu, it doesn't pop up, it doesn't show up. But what you can still do, if I just start typing, it'll still work. So even though the search box doesn't actually exist, you know, now it doesn't actually show up when I open the menu. If I have that search box turned off, if I start typing, it still works. So there we go. So if you don't want the search box there, and you still want to open the start menu, there we go. It still works. Just randomly typing when you open the start menu still shows up. I like having the search box there though, so I can just, you know, click and open Cortana if I want, since I do like Cortana. And of course, I'm a Windows Phone user, so I do use this. Of course, the hamburger menu, different settings for Cortana. All that up, you know, it's the same as before, just the interface is better. And now you can see the actual taskbar, the search box in the taskbar. It looks a lot more integrated now, so it doesn't, you know, stick out like a sore thumb, which is what I like about it. So if I open it up, there we go. So if I click the actual, that's not what I wanted, now it's doing this shit again. You can see when the button highlights there, I'm clicking on it and it's not doing anything. Yeah, it's still a little bit buggy, but hopefully that will be fixed by the time this is actually final. For fuck's sake. No. I don't know what I'm going to do about that. I don't know. I got it to work before. Turn the tapestry button off. I don't like that. Virtual desktops, of course, still exist. So if I just open a couple of windows here. You can see there is the new store as well. You can see it's also got the vertical scrolling. So if I hit Window tab, you can see, there we go. Virtual desktops. If I click New Desktop, there's actually a feature in this which wasn't in there before, and I do like this. I want to open another, for fuck's sake, I want to open another app that's different than Windows Explorer. Jesus Christ. Fine, I'll open a different folder if I go to this PC. There we go. And C drive, there we go. And because my start menu isn't working anymore, fine, let me try resizing. This seemed to work in the VM. Oh, now it pops up, okay. Yep, there we go, I fixed it. Alright, so I just put it back to normal size. Fuck off. Alright. So now if I open, and I want to go, mail. There we go, so if I window tab, you can see I have two desktops. One with mail and Explorer, the other one with, I wanted to hover over that, with the store. And I'll get to those in a minute, the new notifications in a minute. Now, so if I'm on desktop 2, if I use Alt Tab, it will only allow me to choose what's on this desktop. If I go to the other desktop, if I do Alt Tab, see, it only lets me do Store and the Windows Explorer. If I go to desktop number 2, it only lets me do the Mail and the Explorer, the second Explorer window. So there we go. And of course, to switch desktops, all you have to do is hold Control Windows, and then like to do it on the fly, instead of going all the way into this, all you have to do is just go Control Windows and then left or right. So there we go, it still has that. Which that's, has to redraw the taskbar apparently, but there we go. So I do like this, and I was using that in the older build. Oh yeah, so if I just window tab, I'm gonna get rid of desktop 2. There we go, because I don't need it. There's also new sounds in Windows 10 as well. So if I go into change system sounds, there's a whole bunch of new system sounds. So there we go. So if I just my volume all the way up, I have the magnifier on. Sorry, I just need it. So. See a bunch of new sounds, and they actually sound pretty nice, so. Oh, that's an old Windows 8 sound. They haven't changed the device connect sound yet, but one thing I do want is, even though this checkbox still is here, there's no Windows startup sound anymore. I don't know why. The checkbox is still there, and even though I have it checked, in 10,041, it didn't do anything. And I had that checked. And in this build, it doesn't do anything, like in the VM. So, yeah. But I do like the new sounds that they put in, you know. And I hope they, in the phone version, they have the matching ones in there, so it feels like just the One OS. So there we go, that is the notifications, of course. There's Action Center, which I don't like having those expanded. It looks kind of ugly, so. And of course, it's asking for feedback. So there we go. So it says, how satisfied are you to see apps on your taskbar scope to the current desktop? Which, yeah, that's what I was talking about. So I am satisfied. And it's fine. So I'm going to send feedback. There we go. So that, if there's anything else that I didn't do. I want that to move back to where it was. Oh, Project Spartan. I didn't show that off. It's actually the same as it was before, just they fixed it. So I haven't showed this before. I showed 9926 last time. That didn't have this. However, this was in build 1041. So 10,041. So it was in that. So I've already used Spartan, I just haven't showed it on video. Of course, you should have already all seen this now. This is the replacement for Internet Explorer. It's a universal app. So however, they have fixed a few things. Before, you couldn't double click to maximize or restore like you could with everything else, so they put that back in. And they also fixed the favorites bar. So where is the favorites bar? Oh, sure, favorites bar, there we go. So there we go. So now the favorites bar actually, you know, looks like it's working. Because before, like the favorites in there would, like, half of them would be cut off, like the text would be cut off from the bottom, and like half the icon there would be cut off, so. Yeah, I hope, I wonder if you go to these, if the icon changes and doesn't just have a generic icon like that. So if I just say, excuse me, and if I open it again, I hope it just doesn't, oh yeah, it changes, so I just had to refresh the browser there, but yeah. So we go to MSN, I'll have to change that homepage, because I don't like having a homepage. I just like having the new tab page or about blank or whatever. But there we go. So there is Spartan, which I do like the interface now. It actually doesn't look too bad, especially with the favorites bar there. So it looks like something I would use. And of course, it is it does work with touch, so it's also going to work with touch just like the modern version of IE does. So if I go into tablet mode, you can see tablet mode, the start screen is full screen, of course. If I go into Spartan here, There we go. So now it looks like it. So you don't have to close, minimize, and maximize there. And actually, you still. Oh, you have close. But of course, now it works like a tablet. So I can do that. I don't in tablet mode. You can see in tablet mode. You don't the icons. The taskbar icons don't show up. You can change that so that it does do that. You can change it back to the way it was, but by default now the icons don't show up in the taskbar when you're in tablet mode, which it makes it look cleaner. However, what I wish they would do is change it so that icons the taskbar in general doesn't show up because you don't need it. On a tablet, on a Windows tablet, the majority of them have a big Windows button in the center. So having the taskbar there makes no sense in tablet mode, and it's not there in Windows 8. And Windows 8 worked bloody fantastic on a tablet. So let me open one of the new I'll open Mail for tablet mode and see how that looks. So there we go. I don't know what happened there. I tried to resize it. Okay, Mail. Outlook Mail. There we go. So now you can see this is the way it's going to be in tablet mode. So even though this is not a touchscreen, you can see. If I hover up the top here, though, you can see we get the title bar. So I think the way Windows 10's gestures are going to work is if you swipe down, you'll get that title bar. Swipe left, you'll get task view, so you can, you know, the multiple desktops. Swipe right, you'll get, swipe in from the right will bring up Action Center. Swipe in from the left will bring up task view. Swipe in from the top will bring in the title bar, and swipe in from the bottom will bring up the task bar. Although, for now, for me, it's just showing up on, like, all the time, which I don't want it to. But, you can still drag down to close. And now, you can see, the start screen automatically comes back up, just like the way it should on a tablet. So, and you can also see down the bottom there, the icons are also separated a little bit, just for easier touch. So, I really should properly show it. If I should put it on my Surface, just to properly try it out on a tablet. So I am very curious as to how it'll work, but I do rely on my Surface as a tablet, and I want it to work perfect. I want it to work fine. That's why I haven't put Windows 10 on there. That's why I've just put it on this old ThinkPad that, you know, I don't give a shit about. So yes, yeah, so there's tablet mode. Let me just resize that back to the small menu. Oh, for fuck's sake, it keeps moving where I don't want it to. Whatever. Anyway, so that is Windows 10 build 10,074. So there we go. So I hope you enjoyed this. And oh crap, it's gonna do the hybrid shutdown, which it doesn't really work properly on these older computers. Well, it does, but yeah, it hibernates it. So. Yeah, so I hope that's been Windows 10 build 10,074. So I hope you enjoyed this, and thank you for watching. I'll see you in my next video.